Hello and welcome. In this video, I will explain to you the contribution urban farming can make in closing resource loops. For centuries, cities posed a challenge to farmers and food retailers. They struggled to supply sufficient food of good quality to the urban populations. Improvements in infrastructures and in processing and transport technologies have solved this. Modern technologies ensure the speed and safety of urban food. These made it possible to feed very large cities. Nowadays, food waste is a larger problem for most cities than food shortages. These technological innovations still continue. They also change the relationship between cities and food. Urban agriculture, for example, may not be a new phenomenon, but it has become much more feasible today. Nowadays, many urban areas produce food. So what can urban agriculture contribute to closing resource loops? Organic waste and nutrients concentrate in cities. For example, phosphorus is needed to produce food, but the available stocks are limited. Recycling phosphorus would maintain its availability for future generations. But as this balance for the Netherlands shows, much phosphorus ends up in the environment. In developing countries where most household waste is organic, valuable nutrients get lost because household waste is not collected. This graph shows how in Dar es Salaam, the capital of Tanzania, only a small proportion of all household waste is actually collected. So much needs to be done in cities to deal with this loss of nutrients and organic matter. Can agriculture make a contribution to this? Urban agriculture offers hands-on experience with building a circular economy. This is one of the reasons why citizens engage in farming activities. It is also why local authorities support urban food production. Urban farming is visible, delivers direct results, and attracts many people. Urban food closely connects food production and consumption and promotes the reuse of nutrients. Amsterdam's future food cycle illustrates this. Urban governments can facilitate the establishment of short food chains when they support small-scale food production, processing and retail. In some cities, support of such farming activities is already long-standing. For example, in Nairobi, the capital of Kenya, the urban dairy industry is well established. Dairy farmers use organic waste to feed their cows, and this creates income opportunities for thousands of families in the city. Other cities, for example Amsterdam, have addressed urban food more recently. For them, farming is part of a broader view on sustainable urban development. Urban food may contribute to closing nutrient cycles. Green roofs and green community space are included in urban plans. Nutrients and water are managed through small-scale composting systems, rain and greywater reuse techniques, and hydroponic systems. Organic municipal waste can be collected, composted, and used as fertilizer. Nutrients such as phosphorus can be harvested for recycling and reuse. This way, food waste, human and animal waste can serve for productive purposes. There is, however, a risk, the spreading of pathogens and in particular zoonosis. This needs to be closely monitored. Wastewater can also be recycled and used for irrigation in combination with rainwater. This practice contributes to urban water management. Urban food production can also reduce energy demand. Green roofs and rooftop gardens can be insulating, reduce the energy consumption needed for heating, and lower CO2 emissions. Local food production can also reduce the need for food storage, refrigeration, and transport. Urban food production provides an opportunity for resource management, but it is increasingly also supporting livelihood diversification and nutritional security. Urban gardening may not always produce large quantities of food, but it may deliver an essential supply of fresh food in difficult situations. For instance, in Nairobi, Czech gardens provided income and were one of the very few sources of food during the political crisis of 2007. I have presented urban agriculture as a strategy to close some of the resource loops in the city. Some examples from different cities illustrate these possibilities. Now, what do you think? Can urban agriculture be effective in closing the resource loops? And what needs to be done to realize this potential?